Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. This time we don't have any Audi, Seat, Skoda, Volkswagen for you. Our friend dropped us
a Ford.
Yes, it's a Ford. He bought the car on auction. He dropped it to us because it's not boosting at all. I checked the car quickly around and it's not even the quickest one, and it's not even the cleanest one of the STs. So yeah, let's have a walk around the car now. So yeah, this is the beast ST Ford Focus. You can probably see the damage in the front straight away. So I don't really think this is part of the tune. So we will definitely get a new grill, the upper one and the bottom one as well. Also, the turbo is not boosting as I mentioned. I did already check the actuator, which is somewhere over there. And after we start up the engine, I don't really see it moving. I already spoke with a few people and they told me it's a common fault that the wastegate flap basically failed and it just fell apart. So it's not regulating the turbo pressure. And I must say, I do love the color. Probably not everyone is just a Volkswagen or Audi fan who's watching us. So I thought I'm gonna do a short video of the process of this Ford Focus. From inside, bucket seats, looks clean. The first thing what I found is the funny button over there, the start stop button, and it says CP. Also, dent, big dent, that'll be repaired. So it's Collins Performance. I think just the company on Facebook. It looks like there's some kind of a tune company somewhere up north. So I don't know much about what they actually done to the car, but we will probably find out very soon. So yeah, we will do the turbo, some oil change and some basic service. As you can see, like I mentioned, it's not the cleanest car. There are some scuffs and dents and what needs to be done. So yeah. So yeah, all that needs doing. I'm really hoping it will be a sort of a quick job, and I'm gonna put it back on the road. So yeah, let's do it. Okay, let's start it. Ooh, exhaust is done as well. Okay, so yeah, sounds all right. We've got a check tire pressure. Yeah, there's a puncture on the left rear, we know that. So the good thing is we've got oil pressure, but no boost, absolutely no boost. So yeah, we're gonna put the car in now on the ramp. We're gonna sort out the mechanical side of the vehicle first, and then we're gonna do the bodywork, the wheels and whatever needs doing. Let's do it. Okay, so first thing first, we're gonna put a bit of oil flush in there. We're using these BG products, which are very good. We also have them for oil additive and fuel. So yeah, we're gonna put it in. We're gonna leave the engine running with it for probably 15-20 minutes. Then we're gonna drain the oil and we're gonna start taking the turbo out. I'm really hoping it's not hybrid or anything, because that will be very expensive repair then. Left it running, we're gonna drain the oil now. This is the turbo. Never done it before, first time. It looks like an easy job, but you never know. Let's try it. Thank you. Okay, so the dry shaft is out. Bit of a change of the plans. I removed this nut over here, but the bolt was fully stuck. So we have to take the arm off from here, two bolts and two nuts and one bolt. And that's it. Come off so they pop out. And yeah, we will probably remove now these two, which is holding the dry shaft over there. And then it will come out from the gearbox. So yeah, finally a bit of more space. I took the turbo pipes off and we have a clamp here. Oil feed pipes from the top, some water pipes. So we're definitely gonna have to get some gaskets here. And I will still have to take off the vacuum from the top and the intake hose to the turbo. As you can see, there are some brackets. So yeah, we're gonna have to put the car down afterwards. Yeah, let's continue with all this. Then we're gonna go from the top. Alrighty then, so this is the turbo and apparently we find the issue. That's broken, okay. I don't know, looks alright. Anyways, we're gonna get a new unit and it'll be all replaced. I take the pipes off and the vacuum solenoid and stuff, and we're gonna put a new turbo on. Okay, so we've got a new turbo and this is what we're gonna replace now, so it should make it a bit quicker. Okay. Alrighty then, focus back on the ramp. The car off the ramp a couple of days. Unfortunately, Miroslav kicked me out from over there. Because there's an A5 now, and yeah, we finish with the turbo, which is here, but unfortunately, I know you'll be probably pissed off, but that is not going in there. We've got a fully stock turbo, and yeah, that will be installed. I get the new gaskets from Ford as well. Unfortunately, I'm a bit of a disappointed because these gaskets were like very expensive. So yeah, that's why we don't really do too much faults. But yeah, this is the turbo, brand new unit. So that will be installed, and then we're gonna do the bodywork on the car. So let's put this bad boy in now. 1, 2, 3, Polizei. Okay, so clean up the feed pipe and clean up the dump pipe. And yeah, these are the old rings, copper rings, which were sitting on there, so I took them off. And really recommend to replace these all the time. You don't want to have oil leaks from the turbo and my low oil pressure there, so the turbo might go in a while. So yeah, for the money what's Ford asking, you can get a lovely set like we've got, and got different diameters and sizes, so yeah, easy to swap. So yeah, this pipe should go like this, correct? So yeah, easy. And yeah, that goes afterwards, and definitely this one have to go there. That's going from back of the turbo, that needs to be there before we're gonna start putting it in. And once that's done, we're gonna put it in the car. Alrighty then, so put on antifreeze. I put the additive in the oil, top of the fresh oil, change the oil filter. Everything seems to be plugged in. I still have to put a bit of water, and I don't want to start the engine yet. I definitely gonna disconnect the coil packs, and I'm gonna crank the engine a few times so we've got enough oil in the turbo. And then we're gonna try to start it, see how it goes. So let's start it up. Okay then, so mechanical side of the car is probably sorted. Let's take it to our body section now, and probably I'm gonna start stripping the front and the rear bumper, because we have to do a bit of a plastic welding on the front bumper first. We have to jig out the rear quarter panel as well. Oh yeah. Okay, so front bumper, somebody used super glue, so yeah, that's broken. We will probably just plastic weld it back on and fix it. Then this is probably the worst crack on the front bumper, and this is the smaller one where you've seen. So okay, gonna strip the front bumper fully and plastic weld it first, primer it and paint it. Rear bumper. Rear bumper. So yeah, this is the damage on the corner. So yeah, I have to strip it fully as well. Fix this, take all the sensors out, free spray. And second reason why we took the bumper off, you can see the corner here, the paint's just chipping off. So I'm not sure if it was painted before or what happened there. I have to do one quarter panel, and this is the second quarter panel. So yeah. prime the time.
Yeah, I've done the bumpers, done the bonnet, I jigged out the rear quarter panel, everything's repaired, so I'm gonna put the primer on now. Probably gonna leave it over the night to dry up tomorrow. I have to sand everything down with 320 again, 600, and clean up everything for painting. I bought the paint today, so slowly getting there. The only bit and the last thing will be the alloy wheels. I'm not sure if you've seen the stage of them, but definitely need doing so. They will be done as well. I've got the grill, as you can see. And let's primer it. Primered yesterday, and I personally think it looks much better. So I had to take everything off again and start sanding it down, get it ready for painting, and hopefully this week it will be done. Bit ambitious, but yeah, let's do it. Okay, everything is out of the spray boot now, so I'm gonna start putting everything back together again, and afterwards I will start flattening and polishing it. You can see the difference between the old panel, all the marks and scuffs and everything, and the new freshly painted panel. So yeah, you can see the dust that's all gonna come out. So yeah, let's do it. Okay, so if you remember, when I was stripping the car, this was broken, it was glued on. So I took the other bit, which was in the frame, and luckily, it's just broken like this. So gonna plastic weld it, save a bit of the money, and you gotta put it back on.
The job, all those things that can weigh you down. You know, sometimes, just sometimes, you bring that home with you.
Alrighty then, front bumper is on, rear bumper is on. I'm still waiting for the lower grill. Yeah, so that's missing. Don't know where it's going to arrive actually, but never mind. I don't really want to put rest of the stuff back on, like the handles and everything, because I need to flat the paint and start polishing it. Even what I didn't paint needs polishing, because you probably see the stage of the car. So yeah, it will be full detailed, and probably did notice there's no alloys on now. I dropped the alloys earlier this week. Also, the left rear puncture wasn't a puncture on the end of the day, it was a cracked alloy. So, more expensive, but yeah, it needs to be done. And there'll be full refurb back in black gloss. And yeah, I think, and hopefully that will be the last thing. So yeah, if you excuse me now, I have probably 5 or 6 hours of sanding and polishing. So yeah, have to do it. I'll see you soon. Thank you. sort of. I've just done it from the middle edge to the bottom so far. It's pretty clean, it's pretty flat and everything. As soon as you're gonna go higher, you can see how mud it is, and also all the scratches from the sandpaper basically, so all that's gotta be polished. This is just stage one for now. I still have to do it with the offset polish and different paste, and then it's just gonna be cleaned up. So yeah, pretty all right. I will be quite happy with this. I don't have to sand it no more. So yeah, it's just required polishing a few times and it will be a very nice result. Alrighty then, so the car's finally done, everything sorted, and now the funniest part, we can drive it. So I'm gonna take it for a drive. We wanna do some footage outside as well, how it looks like on the sun and stuff, and that's it, all done. But that will not happen, and let me tell you why. Okay, so quick story time. After we had the car delivered, with a boost issue and the bodywork was rough and whatever needs doing, we sorted out everything. The car looks absolutely amazing after we done the paint job, and yeah, we went for a drive for the first time, and the car developed a misfire, so I plug it in, no fault codes. So first I thought probably the traction control is cutting the power because it was pulling very well, so I tried without the traction control, still the same. No fault code still, so we come to the conclusion the coil packs need doing with the spark plugs. After we replaced those, basically the car was all right. So yeah, we put everything in the car, and we went to do some filming outside with the drone and stuff. It was nice weather, so we went to get some petrol. I've done about 5 or 6 miles, and I was doing maybe 40 miles per hour cruising, and with absolutely no warning, I just had a white smoke, loads of white smoke, and this happened. Recovery,
You've probably seen the damage. The engine block has a massive hole. The Conrod from number one went for a small walk, and the engine's fully gone. I have no idea what happened, how it happened, because there was fresh oil, there was new oil filter, the compressions were fine, there were actually no misfire on idle, anything like that. The oil pressure was fine, and there was absolutely no tapping noise, so nothing was warning us before it happened that it will actually happen. So it is what it is. I'm fed up. The owner's fed up because he spent so much money and we are on the beginning basically. And he still wants to do the engine. So probably if you guys interested, and there will be interest, you can leave me a comment if you want to have a part two of the Ford engine rebuild or engine swap, because that engine can't be rebuilded. So we're gonna find a second hand engine or build engine. I don't know yet, but advice, you want to get a car from auction, don't do it. just get a straight car, you've seen it running and everything, because you're probably gonna have a hidden faults like this ST had. Anyways, I did find the previous owner, who you've probably seen on the part of the video, the Instagram name. So I was in contact with him, nice lad. He was interested to buy the car afterwards once it's done, but the engine went, so he's probably not interested anymore. But he told me the car was driven for probably 4 months with no turbo, or the engine wasn't boosting, and it was driven like that. So the only way to find out is take the engine out, open it up, and see what actually happened. But yeah, you're gonna end up with another engine anyways. So thanks for watching anyways, and I'll see you in the next video.